I'm Miss Stephanie. High five, big hug, and a kiss. How can you tell that this fan is turned on? You can't see the wind that it's making because wind is invisible. I know that I can feel it, but how can I prove that to you? Could this pinwheel help? Yes, now you can see that there is a wind because you can see it turning the pinwheel. The only way that you can see the wind outside is by what it moves, like the trees, the branches on the trees, or wind chimes or wind socks, or the leaves on the ground. When they are moving, you know that there is a breeze. Did you know that the original name for the Holy Spirit was wind? That's right. The old Hebrew word for spirit, ruach, means wind. Can you say ruach? That's great. We read in the New Testament that when Jesus left the earth and the Holy Spirit came, there was a mighty wind. And we celebrate that at Pentecost. We also know that when you believe in Jesus and accept him as your Savior, then the Holy Spirit lives inside of you. One of the hardest things to do is to let others see God in us. How can we prove that Jesus is inside us, that his Holy Spirit is blowing through us? It's like the problem with the fan. I had to prove that there was a breeze coming from the fan, and that pinwheel made it so that you could believe me. The moving pinwheel showed that there was a breeze. Our actions prove that God's Holy Spirit is in us. He makes us kind and considerate and joyful and patient, and he gives us other good gifts. Even though others can't see God, when they see these good qualities in us, they will be seeing God at work. What are those good qualities? Well, in the New Testament book of Galatians, the Apostle Paul writes this: "But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. These things will be evident in our lives, and that's how others will know that the Holy Spirit is working in us." Let's pray. Thank you, God, for sending us the Holy Spirit to give us the ability to show others that you are at work in us. We want to feel your Holy Spirit close to us, loving us, helping us always. And all God's children said, Amen. If you want to read the story about the Holy Spirit coming to us at Pentecost, that is found in your Bible in the New Testament book of Acts, chapter 2. If you'd like to read about the fruit of the Spirit that Apostle Paul wrote about, that is in the 5th chapter of Galatians. And that's it for today. If you don't have a Bible and you'd like one, just get in touch with me through the Oakhurst UMC Church office or leave a message in the comments below. We love to give away Bibles. Thanks for joining me on Just for Kids. High five, big hug, and a kiss.
If you appreciated this video and would like to see more great content, please like and subscribe to all of our Oakhurst UMC channels. Also, sharing is caring.